arms, raised to the high heavens like Simba, she had given birth to a 7-pound-9 demolition handsome bloke that looks exactly like me. She'd say it was the labor pains, but she's talking smack. The last time I made my mother cry was the first time I felt the safety of her intertwined fingers unravel into fists. She was about this close to hooking me into next week. She did it. And it was in that moment I learned, tears speak for the heart when words are too much. Mom, I wish I could tell you back then that your eyes would spend more time flying across skylines than they do spilling out oceans. Your brown eyes don't suit you. So you lift your gaze to where the waves kiss the clouds and you can settle on my horizon. I know it's a bit far, but I promise you I'll be rising like the tone in your voice when you tell me off, like it's 7:30, we're gonna be late, like palms on June 25th, 98, like expectation, like sun in the morning, I am the sun in the morning. Do you hear me cry? Because I can really use that shoulder right now. Mom, you raised me right. Better than anyone ever could have. A rape and an ethos of excellence and respect, respond and act on to come correct when I am wrong. Uphold the standard, and when I'm feeling sleepless, sleep less and work smarter, because time is infinite and life isn't, isn't it? You're not gonna be around forever. You've taught me that too. You've also taught me that hands turn red when you get a slap. Like, remember the time I picked the pockets of Big Man? How it all 85 cents in my hand and you had all the swift slaps in the other. It was obvious because I was so bad that these hands weren't made for steering. They were made to raise, uplift, and defend. Instead they conflict, dismiss, and depend. Instead they cultivate this culture that I love to love but should learn to hate because it eats away at the man I am today. Or the man I should be. See, I get scared. I always find the safety in our small numbers. See, I get scared. Because there will come a time when you do not walk this road anymore. There will come a time when I will have to put you in the ground. There will come a time when you will die. Hopefully before me. And I'm not quite ready for that just yet. My hands can't quite come to grips with holding on to myself if you're gone. Mom, who else is going to be here? Who else is going to be there to tell me that everything's going to be okay? That my hair is looking a bit messy today, that my hair is looking a bit messy today, that my life serves a purpose, that I'm worth it. My identity is portraying itself. That if you can't help me and take my weapon off the shelf, that I'm ready, that I got this, that I'm doing good, that I'm doing bad. That one day, when you fade away, when I am old and grey, still devilishly handsome, my heart can hear you say, look at myself.
Yeah!